Well, I went and got mail today, and I got some stuff that I ordered. Thought I'd share with you. Put that on the side for now. This is, can't remember what the heck I've got. Okay. This is some stuff called InstaMorph. And get this out of the way. And what you do is you put a few little bit of this stuff, it's little plastic beads or something, and you put it in water. And you can make tools, you can make, you can even make a handle for a saw out of it, and it hardens up into a real hard plastic. You can even make little hangers for on the wall. It's just, it's really kind of cool. You gotta water 140 Fahrenheit or 60 Celsius, and you pour in a few nodules of this stuff, and it, you know, you wait 2 minutes and it becomes plastic or malleable. You pick it up out of the water and then you start molding it. And let's see, how long did it take to harden? It doesn't say here, but it doesn't take very long, I'm a-thinking. Anyway, I just thought I'd try this out, and I might try this in the studio tomorrow or at home. 140 degree water, that would have to be boiled, I'm thinking. So I'll take that home and try that out. And this is, if you didn't know it, I'm going to be doing a workshop in Texas at the end of this month, the 30th, 31st, and the 1st, and down in Grapevine, Texas. And I sent away for the same tools they're going to be using in the workshop, so that I'm not using something more elaborate than they are. And I got some cards to hand out when I get down there. Got this from sculpturedepot.net, and looks like some great tools. Let me go through them. These are the tools that I've recommended for all the people taking the class. And so I'm going to take this out of the wrapper. This is, you zoom in on it. I don't think it's going to get much closer than that without going out of focus. So this has got a round tip on it, which I think these round tips, which I've just started using the last couple of years, are really, really something to have. And then this has got a nice flat on this side and kind of a rounded surface on this side on the other end. This is another metal tool that I also purchased, and which is available for the students to purchase. And this got a little tiny round ball on this end. I think you can see it, yeah. Put my hand in front of it. Anyway, it's got a round ball on that end, which is really handy. These tiny little round balls can really shape things nicely. Here's a wire tool that I ordered, and it's number 405A, number 405A modeling tool. And it's got a serrated edge on one side and a smooth edge on the other side, and of course a spatula type thing. I usually cut these things off, but I'll leave it on for the class. And sales receipt. And then this is tool number 610. These little tiny wire tools are extremely handy for shaping stuff and finishing off things that are small. We're just going to be working small on a 12 inch figure, and I figure they really don't need anything bigger than this. And got this tool as well, which is real handy for, you know, doing stuff. It's, you don't want to get stuff, tools for oil clay that are made for water clay, because they're not adapted for it, and you can't get the textures that you want. And then I got this tool. This is really handy. Flat on this side, curved, nice rounded edges and surface here, and same here. I'll try to remember to put those numbers up. Now that's the tools and that we're going to be using in my workshop. I think the workshop is pretty well filled up. I'm not certain on that, but last I heard they had just about jam-packed, which is going to be fun. Scary though, because I've never given a workshop before. And these cards, of course, and I'll hand out to the students as well. All right, I think it's time to get busy on this dog. And I think what I'm going to do is take the measurements so that I can make a wood base for it so I can work on this separate. And I'm going to go, looks like it's going to be 10 by 5 1/4, 10 or 5 1/2. And that's going to add some size to this base, and I may have to try to work out this base a little bit too. So, let's see how much more I have to add on to this base. Probably 15 inches there. All right, I'll get busy on that, and I'll be back. I'm afraid this is going to have to be the last thing I do today, because I just got a call from a friend who needs my help and with a project, and so I told him I'd be over, and just going to glue these anyway, so they're going to have to sit overnight. What I'm doing is, to make the base bigger, I need to make a bigger base for the base that I've got now to sit on. And I put these screws through the this 1 by 12, and the screws are popping through, so it was too dangerous for my hands. So I decided I'm going to glue these down and use the screws to hold the wood in place while the glue set up. And then I remove the screws in the morning. So that's what I'm going to do, and this should work out really good. Into a nut. Get this. Hold it a little bit. Whoop, lost it. All right, I'm not a carpenter. What can I say? Flip this over so you can see what I'm talking about. You see all these little tiny screws? That would not be good. All right, that's going to be it for today. I'm going to let this sit overnight and harden up. I mean, well, whatever. Dry or whatever it does. And hopefully it'll all hold together. And I'll see you guys tomorrow.